how to experiment with herbs, and really much more than herbs, supplements, diet changes, lifestyle hacks. Really, if you want to get better results in your health or any other area, then conducting experiments in your life, and not necessarily scientific experiments. We're going to cover the difference between some different ways of looking at this, but by doing this sort of thing, you learn along the way and you figure out the things that work for you individually. Because here's the truth, nothing works for everyone 100% of the time. It doesn't matter if it's scientifically verified in order to do that. That doesn't necessarily mean it works for you. So even with a lot of scientific verification, if we have that, we don't know if it works individually, so you have to conduct an experiment. So let's get into the details, and we're going to go from the hypothesis down to the results and the protocol, everything in between. Let's get into it. The first thing I want to cover is different ways you might conduct an experiment. So the first option is to go for something that resembles a scientific experiment. Even if you're just doing it by yourself, which would be an N equals one, like one subject in this experiment, you can treat it in a scientific way where you are trying to isolate a single variable. So let's say you take one herb and you notice what happens. You take that for a period of time and you note the before and the after. The problem with this style of doing things is, one, life is messy. Things may get in the way. So even though you're trying to isolate a single variable, you're probably not really isolating a single variable. There could be various things that happen in your life that affect your sleep, affect your stress levels. Is your diet and your training, is that exactly going to be the same? Now, even if some of those things change, you can still look at this. But I like to more focus on option number two. In this option, we do a whole bunch of things all at once. Because ultimately, in doing an experiment for yourself, you're not so interested in isolating single variable generally, but you're interested in getting results. And what that means is, let's throw 20 different things towards this aim and see what happens. More than likely, even if some of them don't work at all, you're going to have enough there that you're going to be able to swing the hinge. You're going to be able to get results. And from that place, you have results. Mostly, that is what people want with an experiment. Then you can start to subtract things out and see if there's specific ones that work for you there. Because we can't look at this in just a reductionistic frame, which is what science really goes for. Because with herbs, with all kinds of other stuff, there can be synergy between them. So even though A might not work and B might not work for you, the combination of A plus B for some reason does work. That's what makes this really complicated. And in the end, I would think most people are looking for results. But I do want to say, if you do this approach and you find all these things that work for you in whatever way that might be, something you can then do is get rid of half of them or get rid of some of them and see if those results still stand. Get rid of more things, see if those results still stand. So this way you can find something that works first, you can get those results faster, and then begin to eliminate, to try to narrow it down and find which of the variables are most important for you. So next up, I want to talk about conducting this experiment. Any experiment starts with a hypothesis. And you don't need to spend a whole lot of time on this, but what is the thing you are trying to achieve? What are the ways in which you are trying to achieve that? If you're taking herbs, what do you expect these herbs to do for you? Like, say, if you're taking some of our hormonal herbs, are you hoping to raise testosterone in doing that? And then are you measuring it? How are you actually measuring this difference? Are you going to be taking before and after blood tests? Or saliva tests or anything like that? Or are you just basing this on how you feel? Both of these are applicable, good ways of doing it, and you can do an experiment either way. So what is your hypothesis? What is the protocol that you're doing? Real simple, if you're just doing a single herb, or you could do 10 different herbs and 10 different lifestyle changes. Put that all together, but detail that out so you know what you're going for. Then how long are you following this sort of protocol for? I would recommend somewhere between like 2 and 6 weeks in conducting an experiment. So I mentioned a little bit about how are you going to tell the difference, but how are you going to track this along the way? Are you just measuring before and after? Are you looking at things along the way? In addition to just looking at how you feel, even though that's a subjective thing, it can be made more objective by rating things on a scale of 1 to 10. For instance, so how do you feel as far as energy in the morning? what is your mood? You can rate these things along the way. That way it is made a little bit more concrete, because you know, it's hard to remember 3 weeks back, how were you feeling when you woke up in the morning, right? So measuring these things along the way really helps out. But if you're doing something like a blood test before and after, that's a bit different. And as I said before, you can really combine these things. So what is your time frame in doing this? 2 to 6 weeks, something like that. And if you put all this together, you will have conducted an experiment. After you have done that, look at the information. What worked? What did not? What are you going to take from this? Continue doing. What are you going to scrap and go back to the drawing board with? Are you going to launch right into another experiment right after this? Lots of different options. So I hope this video really helped you dial in or start thinking about how are you going to conduct these sort of health experiments for yourself, because an experimental attitude, that is what allows you to do things and learn from them and thus get better in the process. I'm all for people getting results, and I really like that option too of throwing a whole bunch of things out there to do that. If you actually take that seriously, more than likely you're going to get some results. Even if it's not quite to where you want to be, getting part of the way there is a step in the right direction. I have a whole article that goes along with this video. If you're not watching it on the blog here, be sure to check that out. Link probably down below this video, and that'll take you more info. And of course, we have tons of other information on herbs, on case studies of people conducting experiments like this. And I'll mention something new we're starting here at Lost Empire Herbs is if you give us before and after blood tests or some other experimental protocol you followed and detail out stuff like we've talked about here, we are going to give you credit for many of our amazing herbs, any of our amazing herbs at Lost Empire Herbs. So thank you very much for watching, and I look forward to talking to you once again in the future.